Hello everybody, this is Enderman Gucci and today I'm gonna record a video Legacy with Grixis Control. So the reason why I play this deck is that I wanna try something out. There's a Grand Prix Lille very soon and I will be playing there for sure. I'm still undecided about the deck. I'm considering Sultai Delver, Marako, and I discovered this deck, which is based on Young Pyromancer. Is like only creature you can see here, Truename Nemesis and Balfour Strix as well, but these are just something that I want to try, but the base of this deck is Young Pyromancer. So the plan is to play a lot of cantrips, cards like Brainstorm Ponder, Preordain, Energy Dexion Probe to fuel your graveyard for cards like the Dig Through Time, and then you get to win the game, as I said, with Young Pyromancer or eventually taking the game over. Truename Nemesis is a very difficult card to beat. Here we have the combo Cabal Therapy Jitaxian Probe, which is great. You can Jitaxian Probe your opponent, see what he has, and then Cabal Therapy him. And Cabal Therapy is also great with Young Pyromancer because it actually doesn't cost you anything. If you have a token in play and Pyromancer in play, you can sacrifice the token, play Cabal Therapy, and you get another token into play. So I play Balfour Strix, which is not a card that you see often in Legacy, because it's a blue card for Force of Will. It's a creature that kills basically, because you have problem to deal with big creatures. Cards like Tarmogoyf or Tazigur are kind of difficult to deal with because they don't die to Lightning Bolt, which is your only removal, along with this Singleton of Murderous Cat. So you have more ways to interact with your opponent. Then there's Counterspell, which is the other way to deal with difficult to deal. And Snapcaster Mage, that since you have so many you have so many spells, you can easily flashback them, like Lightning Bolt and stuff like that. I love playing a lot of one-off like Pyroblast and etc, because with four Dig Through Times you can easily find what you need at the right moment. The mana base is only 17 land, which is strange to call a control deck a deck with only 17 lands, but with so many cantrips you don't want to flood out and you just want to stop at like four lands and don't even be in a hurry to hit them regularly, because your curve is very low, so you can control the game with even 2-3 lands. Then we pass to the sideboard, where you have a lot of counterspell. Cards like Flusterstorm, Pyroblast, Red Elemental Blast are for the Omnitel matchup. Then we have Blue Elemental Blast, which you can board in against multiple decks, or also board in against the deck that run Red Elemental Blast, because actually you want to resolve your Dig Through Times, and decks like Miracle will board in as many as Red Elemental Blast as they have. So you can play Blue Elemental Blast to fight their Red Elemental Blast. It's kind of complicated, but it works. I got to Blue Elemental Blast twice a Red Elemental Blast. That's kind of funny. Then you have Innocent Blood and Diabolic Edict to kill against deck that has a lot of creature decks, like Deathrite Bug with Deathrite Shaman and Tarmogoyf, if you wanna kill them. Perish once again against green creature. Then you have Forked Bolt, which I'm not sure if it's better than Marshka's Dualities, since Marshka's Dualities kills Nemesis and Young Pyromancer, along with a lot of elves. But Forked Bolt, I think, is more versatile. You can board in against the Delver deck and the Deathrite Shaman deck. Blood Moon is basically only for decks that really have problem to deal with that, because you are playing only one island. So Blood Moon can lock up you too. So should be there just for like the matchup where it's really now to win, just like Sultai or Lands or I don't know. Then we have two Pity Needle and one Null Rod to fight Sunset Divine Top and Battle School and Jite. This deck has problem to deal with artifacts. So sorry, to deal with the equipment. So an old rod is useful for that. Pithy Needle is always useful for against Miracle, which is not a great matchup because Counterbalance is a difficult card to deal with. Another difficult card to deal with for this deck is Rest in Peace, since you don't have any way to remove an enchantment, and Rest in Peace is very difficult for you to deal with because it will counter basically your Dig 3 times, the Murderous Cast, enough cast damage, and Cabal Therapy. And then also, so some deck run Echoing Truth, which I'm not very sure about its strength. I don't love bounce spell, they just do card disadvantage, and this deck, I don't think that card belongs to this deck. Someone runs also Tazigur, but I don't know, there are too many dealt cards at that point. I prefer playing Murderous Cat. Some deck run Duck Faden, some deck run Jace. But I think this is the configuration that I like, and we'll see how it goes in the daily event.